children of gods, and heed my tale of time's beginning. All was dark. There was no sand. There was no sea. No earth, nor sky. No grass, nor wind. Till fire met ice in the gasping void. And from this green came the giant Ymir, first of all beings. Proud Ymir, cruelly killed. Yet from whose bones and blood and brains the world was made. The world you walk and war upon.
There you are.
Here's a tune for you. Want to liven your step?
Ah, oh, there you are, my little drinker.
Go. So, you see our king? Find the ring. Yes. Now for our little plan. You see us talking. Quiet as a wood mouse. And then surprise him with our gift. And you hold it out like this. You look him in the eyes and you say, Styrbjörn King, may our clans be forever bonded in friendship and in love. I think you can do that for me. Tonight, you will be the court that unite our people. I'm so proud of you, Eivor.
Get up, Olaf. Stay lucid, friend.
My sword is grown greedy. I'm ready to fight.
So nice having all of these hearty folk in our hall.
Drink in your fist? Come on, I'll find you something.
I can't. I have a tribute for your father.
Oh, what a piece. That must be worth two sturdy longships. Give it here. I'll pass it on.
My father asked me, Sigurd.
Suit yourself. You're not getting any mead.
Like a satyr works through my hammer.
When you speak with the king, hold it up to the light. Show him the fine details. See there? I etched his name in runes on the outer band. You'll show him?
Mm-hmm.
You're just like your father, little berserker. Skull to you.
Skull!
You see? She agrees.
So, you have the ring? Good. This was worn by your grandfather in a battle on the Northern Way.
Mother?
Yes?
Can we show Sigurd the can stones we stacked yesterday?
That's a good idea. We'll do that in the morning. First light.
Eivor, wait.
Skål! To Sturbjell! The true king of Gurgafolga! Tonight, we are all made anew! Skål!
Eivor.
King. May our clans be forever bonded in friendship and love.
Thank you, Eivor. Now and forever, I am pledged to you.
Hearken well in Hall of Kings. On ocean steed, my words gain wings. Odin's mead I forth will bring. The brave men slain, Valkyria wakes. Rewards for strain to Valhalla takes. And horns resound the mighty horn. For those who fight! For those who fall!
Are under attack! Kjotve's clan!
Ready yourself, men!
Not you, Eivor. Not just yet.
Curtains are raised. Nothing is true until it is severed from the branches of Yggdrasil.
Oh.
All right, wait here.
Now it's my turn to offer you a deal, slave. Accept your fate, die a coward here before your people. And I will spare the rest.
Fight, my love! Do not listen!
If I give my life, will you spare my clan?
You have my word.
No. No, Varen. No, Varen! Pick up your axe!
No!
Kill them all!
DNA. Not sure why.
Fix this or pull me out.
I can parse the streams with a filter. Hold on. Okay, we're good.
Are we?
I don't know what happened, but I can work around it. You'll have to pick a stream to keep things stable. There's a third option, too. I can let the Animus modulate your identity based on signal strength. It's up to you. Lock it in and push ahead to a time where these streams are more synchronized.
How long have you been chasing me, Wolfkissed? 17 winters? 18. Do I now haunt your dreams? Do I warm your loins? You remember this? Ah, your father's axe. The weapon of a coward. A scorn snake. Ah. Few things would please me more than to kill with this blade. But I know you would defy me to the death, fighting for a glorious end. That I will not allow. You will live your final days, enthralled as a slave. Humiliated. Your death will be a lonely one. Kill the rest of our crew! Make them suffer! Eivor Wolfkissed is no more! That name is dead to this world!
You will be worth your weight in silver. To the ship!
And I take your eyes, you hear me?
Wind's blowing from the south.
We can tack north, then cut west. Now, what did I just tell you?
In danger. I need to reach them. Better. Stronger. Save that for later. Kjatve's men. I need to be careful. Best not to draw attention here. What do you see, Sunan? Thank you. Chutvis warriors. I should stay out of sight. This area is off limits. clash of iron. There is fighting nearby. Dag, you old hound. You live.
I do. Slipped away in the sword clash. And what of you?
Kjotve tried to sell me off. A mistake he'll regret.
Not today, he won't. I saw him board a ship at Avald's Nest not long ago. Sailed east, leaving our crew behind.
There must still be time to save our men. I will find them. You ready the longship.
You glory hound! You would take the rescue for yourself, so the victory song is written about you!
I could storm the beach then, slay 2 dozen men, seize our dragon boat, and hoist the sail in triumph. Up to you.
No, no, I will take the beach. A far more dangerous path. You search the longhouse for our crew. Oh, and here. This corpse will not have need of it.
Go. I'll meet you by the ship.
Sunin, guide me.
Kjotve's warriors crawl through Avald's Nest like lice.
If I use the main gate, I may attract attention.
Go, my eyes.
This place is heavily guarded. Longhouse. My crew should be inside. Should be an opening in the roof.
like that, and my axe will miss your neck. Unpleasant for both of us.
If I'm to die, I want to make a mess of it, Bakraut. You coward! Unbind me and stick an axe in my hand!
I owe you nothing, raven shit. Yours is a clan of thralls and peasants.
You! Lay that axe aside or die by mine!
You should be on a slave ship to Ireland, Wolfkist! But if you wish to be my first sacrifice, Odin will be more than happy to receive you.
You just killed yourself, Erki.
Meteor, I will sell you to Hel herself! Kneel, Wolfkist, and I will spare your life.
Shut your hole and fight!
Die, you sack of shit!
Father, you should have held on to this until the bitter end.
If I give my life, will you spare my clan?
Vedin, no! Pick up your axe!
Kill them all!
No!
Eivor, are you bewitched? Unbind us!
What? Oh. Yes, of course.
Orange be kind, Wolfkist.
Even if your wits were somewhat rattled.
Listen here. If you can breathe, you can fight. Now come. We take back our ship.
You do not need to tell us twice.
What happened here then?
Help me out here! What happened to you then?
Stay sharp.
Definitely not a sin.
Thank you.
Grab your oars! The whale road leads us home!
Gods, it's about time!
Stop yapping and start rowing!
Run up the sail!
Anything to say for the mess you led us to?
We suffered no losses in this fight, and the men who humiliated us are dead. What is there to say?
Oh, something like, I was stupid, selfish, reckless, blind, boneheaded, and I smell like blood and shit?
I like my version better. See you, old friend.
Gnu, Raun og Rif. Sailor!
Eivor, look! Someone is setting up an outpost on that island.
Cut this man. Gnawing at any piece of open land like dogs worrying a bone.
Even with you half in the grave, we could easily take them.
No shame in
suffer!
Finn um dir, Griepart.
Jotve will come for us now, harder and stronger than before.
No surprise there. This war has spun on for 3 generations. I hardly expect him to relent.
Your hatred for that man burns bright, Wolfkist. I could warm my balls on it.
Would you not prefer a pair of sealskin breeches?
Just take care, Eivor. Such hatred can make you careless. What he did to your father, he did to all of us. You are not in this fight alone. King Styrbjorn will scold you for setting out against his wishes.
Of course he will.
Is that not something you worry over?
I worry only that our king will not see that I am right until it's too late.
What about Sigurd? What would he say?
If Sigurd were here, he would be sitting beside you, wiping the blood from his axe and smiling into the breeze.
And what will you tell our king about this misadventure?
Only the truth. We attacked Jotve's fortress, killed his men, and weakened his control of this land.
Will you mention the part where you lost your crew and were nearly sold as a thrall? Will that be part of your saga?
There's a skull who dares sing that verse. It'll be his last song. Let's sail!
Hey, leader!
The dock. Well, well, the feeder of ravens returns, and not half dead. We thought we had lost you, Eivor, for good this time. A warm welcome as always, Ranvi. You look like reddened shit. What happened? Nothing to crow about. Except to say the men who delayed us are dead. And how are you? Well enough. Though I have spent many tiresome days calming the rages of our king. He is not happy with you. I expected as much. And what of Sigurd?
Has he returned from his raids?
My husband should be home today. The last we heard, he was approaching Stavanger.
Good to hear. We have need of his courage.
Sigurd will not save you from his father's wrath, Eivor. You should know that by now.
Did your raid not go as planned?
They rarely go as planned. We killed many of Kjotve's warriors. And there was this. My father's axe among the dead.
Ah. After so many years. You should take it to Gunnar. He will give it back its edge.
A good idea. After I see our king.
That I do not advise. Not yet. He is meeting with a messenger from the north.
I can wait.
A cloud hangs over you. Is something wrong?
Seeing my father's axe after 17 winters. It stirred something in me. A feeling I have not had since. Since the day he was killed. Since the day I got this.
Memories of past agonies. Of sadness and pain.
I should speak with Volka. She could help me make sense of my feelings.
Take your time getting settled. I will see you at the Longhouse.
I think you have lost your edge, Eivor. Just like that axe. Maybe Gunnar can help you with both.
I will let you know.
Eivor! Looking rough you are. Welcome home!
Did you bring us any treasure?
I returned with a boat and a full crew. That is worth more than silver.
That doesn't count. You need silver. And jewels. Shut up, Ralph. How do you know? You never went on a raid. Just shut up.
Caught anything?
Not today. The fish aren't biting. Too many passing boats churning the water.
I lack the patience for pole fishing. I would have better luck with my bow.
Shooting fish with a bow? That could work. Hello, Eivor.
Is there no one who will go around with...
Hey, Tekla. What is brewing?
Alvis tells me this brew is too strong. Think you can handle a few rounds?
Haraldur er Haraldur. Megi eigi gera mitt, eigi mætt ganga í þér og sjá hvort afla muni koma af.
Staggering already.
You can match horns with me. Outdrink every one of you. Don't feel bad. Most of these backgrounds would have pissed themselves or passed by now. Is there no one who will go around with me?
All right, Tekla. I'll outdrink you. Hey, Tekla. What is brewing?
Alvis tells me this brew is too strong. Think you can handle a few rounds? Outdrink every one of you. Don't feel bad. Most of these backgrounds would have pissed themselves all past by now. Is there no one who will go around with me?
Okay. I have those if you want them. Nothing more?
I have to go. See you soon.
Well, look who it is.
Practicing your wordplay, Alvis.
Ah, Eivor! The only mouth in Midgard from which I fear mockery.
You taught me the art of writing poetry, old friend. It is only natural that I surpass you soon.
How about another lesson, then? A quick flight. Right here, right now. What do you say?
Let's try flighting.
I always put a few coins down as a wager. Most of those who enjoy flighting have an equal fondness for betting. But today, we'll abstain. Let me begin.
I'm ready.
In flighting, it's key to match cadence and rhyme. It's as much about sound as it is about time. So be careful in choosing the words that you say.
With your teachings, I'm sure my next challenger I will slay.
No. The rhyme is good, but too many words upsets the rhythm. Now, let us examine meaning. In flighting, you'll need to be cutting and keen. It's about wielding wit more than venting your spleen. If I tell you you're foolish and stupid and dull...
Then I tell you, you've nothing inside of your skull.
Eh, a good response. I called you stupid and you turned it around. Fighting about wit, you matched my meaning. When you think of too many perfect retorts, use the one that best matches the meaning. Last one. So go then and conquer the world with your wit. Go be clever, be quick, show your spirit and grit. I look eagerly forward to seeing how you fare.
I will flight you with flourish and best you with flair.
Perfect, yes! You could destroy me with such a line. Your flighting's astounding, you're worthy of praise. You swing a fine axe and you turn a good phrase.
Thank you, Alvis. I'll take the lesson to heart. Gunner, I have something here you might like to see.
Thunderclap of Thor! Is that your father's axe? I have not seen this beauty since, well, for some time. I forged this weapon long ago. Still looks good. One of my finest, I think.
It has a blunted blade, but it swings well. Can you sharpen it?
I can give it a better edge and reinforce the helm. And as luck would have it, I have one ingot left for the job.
Are you sure?
The fates have willed it so. But in future, bring your own metal ingots. I cannot forge them from empty air. That should do it. Anything else?
How are you, Gunnar? Holding up?
Yeah, work is good and my spirits are strong, but my nights are newly cold. My lady left me, if you have not heard.
I had. Sorry to hear it. You were together how long?
5 weeks it was. 5 beautiful, passionate weeks. But all that is done. Will I never find my Brunhilde?
Valkyries do not walk the world as they once did, Gunnar. Maybe set your sights a bit lower.
Lower? My friend, look at my wares, my weapons. I'm not a man to settle for less than the finest of anything.
That is all for now.
Return any time.
Hey, can you point me to some good hunting grounds?
I could. But I don't want every iron foot with a bow scaring away the game. Bring me 3 deer antlers to prove your skills, and I might just have a story for you.
A worthy challenge. I'll see you soon. Have a look, Sunan. I need your eyes, my friend. Hmm. Amuram.
Volka?
Hush. I need silence to hear the songs of nature. Hamuram. Hamuram.
Svala.
She gives praises and she is greeted.
For your hearing, I hearken. O ancient ones, great Odin, great Freya, I give you thanks for your gift of Seidr.
She gives thanks and she is blessed.
Eivor, it has been some time. What brings you so far to see me?
I have come for your advice. On a private matter.
Come.
Is your mother well?
Her mind is a jumble. She speaks to spirits. I fear her final winter has come. But she has me. Now, let her speak to your needs.
I have had a vision. A powerful vision. It may have been my battle lust, or a delirium caused by the cold, but...
Describe it for me.
After 17 years, I saw my father's axe again. And when I touched it, the vision came on fast. There was a wolf, howling and fierce. And then a figure. A greybeard in a cloak. With a single eye. He bid me follow him.
The High One. He calls to you. Perhaps he means to speak with you, deliver a message. Only through Seidr will you see more clearly, and unravel the threads that sit tangled upon your mind. This will not take long.
What are you brewing?
An elixir to loosen your hugur and unwind your thoughts. You will enter a waking sleep and journey to the world of dreams. It may confuse or disorient you, but you must take note of all you see. Drink. If you seek true understanding.
I saw nothing, Volka. Felt nothing.
Harvey!
Harvey.
Harvey!
Do I walk among the dead? Sigurd.
Sigurd! Brother!
When did you arrive?
Thank you.
euch! Oh.
Brother! What is this?
There was no other way, Javi. Our fates are fixed.
Take it!
This was not for you, Javi.
Steady, Eivor. It is Valka. I am here.
God! I thought I... What was that?
Tell me everything.
I was on a mountain, in a violent blizzard, climbing toward the summit, following a wolf.
Mm-hmm.
I saw Odin and the Nornir spinning the threads of fate. They were watching me.
Not watching. They were showing you the way forward. Your life, your path, what lies before you, and where it ends.
And the wolf was eager for my attention, as if it were beckoning me to follow.
You are the Wolfkist, fated to carry its mark for life. In this case, it might represent your ambition, or your fear.
I saw the gates to Odin's Hall of Slain Champions. They opened for me.
Shades of Valhalla, for which you are destined.
I do not know what else to say. My memories are faint, hazy.
Did you reach the summit of this mountain?
I did, yes. Sigurd was there, wounded, in pain. His fighting arm was missing. Then the wolf reappeared, the size of a dragon. Twisted and terrible. It fixed its eyes on me and struck. Then I woke.
The gods favor you, Eivor. They always have. You will have your glory, and you will earn your place in Valhalla. But these portents carry a darker truth. The missing arm, the trail of blood, the beast. You will betray your brother, Sigurd. That is the meaning of your vision.
That cannot be right. I would never betray Sigurd. He's my brother, my family.
The Nornir have spoken, and this is their message.
No, this is wrong, or you misunderstand. That cannot be right.
You will betray Sigurd.
Odin fought against his fate. It can be done.
Thank you.
So Ivan is asleep on his watch. That would explain some things.
Ivan! Wake up, or you'll be cast into the wild.
Must stay awake. They could be anywhere.
Is he walking in his sleep?
They are everywhere. If we die, everyone dies. Must not fall asleep. Need to see them coming.
Ivan, wake up! You're headed for the edge!
Is he going to ride the rope slide?
Ivan! Ivan! Calm down. You are asleep.
No! I was flying through the air!
In your sleep. A harsh awakening, true. But at least you live. Have you always taken these dream walks?
Since my posting here. When I am in bed, I worry about ways we could be attacked. When I'm on watch, I cannot stay awake.
Only a fool stays awake all night worrying. You're tired when you get up, and the problem is still not solved.
You speak with the wisdom of Odin, Eivor. I will think on these words when I am in bed.
Consider them on your watch, and sleep when in your bed. But now, report back before you're labeled a deserter. Go!
be my eyes soon.
I'll be the one to find it. Just you wait and see.
It must be around here somewhere. I think there are some spots you missed.
What are these men hunting for?
My coat. Whoever finds it wins an evening
I'll
of my company.
I'll be the one to find it. Just you wait and see.
Care to join them? It must be around here somewhere.
Phrases. I think this is yours.
Halt in your search. A winner. and my comb have been found. Now, the price for finding my comb is some of my time. A walk in nature, maybe more, if that is where our conversation takes us.
I see. Lead on.
You're different than the kind my flights of fancy attract. Burdened, decorated, and delicate.
Delicate?
The others, they are like clubs. Blunt and ungainly. You are nimble. Like a knife.
Are you so in need of suitors that any passing woodsman or vikinger will do?
I was married once. My Alfie died 5 winters back. Ours was a perfect marriage. I do not need another. But am I to go the rest of my days without love or attention? I think not.
And the comb?
Could be a comb, could be a brooch, or an arm ring. So long as it's lost, and to be found by a helping hand.
Any good tales come of this?
Once I thought the same man had stumbled across me 3 times. Gave me a fright. Turned out to be triplets.
If this comb is worth nothing to you, what shall I do with it?
You could keep it. Comb your hair. Or I could comb it if you like.
Comb my hair? Is that why those men scrambled over each other?
I could do more than comb your hair. Find all your nuts and snags and tame them, if you'd like.
Thank you for the offer, but I cannot. Here, your comb.
You keep it. It was a reward for my champion. Farewell.
None living here. Not now. But I have a better proposition than a rousing hunt. If you are a true Drenger, a warrior with honor running like sunlight in your veins, then you may help me fulfill my destiny.
You're a long way from any warm hearth, warrior. Is this where you call home?
My name is Erik Loyalskull. The great King Ragnar Lothbrok named me such. When we fought tearing up the fields of England, we built families, overthrew kingdoms, sailed mountains, fought for whole seasons. Now he is gone.
All of Norway laments the passing of King Ragnar. I cannot imagine the sorrow his warriors now feel.
We are but six who remain, his most loyal Drengir. Yet without his guiding light, his strength and vision, we are lost. It was in this cavern that I knew my life was tied to Ragnar's. We were young, hunting a bear, when we chanced upon this spot. He killed it with nothing but a knife. Leapt on its back, held tight, writhing like a fly on a dragon, he stayed put. And it was done. So, together we celebrated the kill. As if we had felled the beast together. That is when I knew I would live and die for this man. I did not die beside my lord in Alli's pit of snakes. But I can make amends. Fight me, warrior. Send me to meet him in Odin's hall.
It is with great honor I will fight a true Drenger, when you're ready.
Very well. For Ragnar Lothbrok, the true King of Norway.
For Ragnar, for glory, for the wandering Drengir do I raise my blade.
Your corpse!
you come looking for bears. There are none living here. Not now. But I have a better proposition than a rousing hunt. If you are a true Drenger, a warrior with honor running like sunlight in your veins, then you may help me fulfill my destiny.
You're a long way from any warm hearth, warrior. Is this where you call home?
My name is Erik Loyalskull. The great King Ragnar Lothbrok named me such. When we fought tearing up the fields of England, we built families, overthrew kingdoms, sailed mountains, fought for whole seasons. Now he is gone.
All of Norway laments the passing of King Ragnar. I cannot imagine the sorrow his warriors now feel.
We are but six who remain. His most loyal, Drengir. Yet without his guiding light, his strength and vision, we are lost. It was in this cavern that I knew my life was tied to Ragnar's. We were young, hunting a bear, when we chanced upon this spot. He killed it with nothing but a knife. Leapt on its back, held tight, writhing like a fly on a dragon, he stayed put. And it was done. Together we celebrated the kill, as if we had felled the beast together. That is when I knew I would live and die for this man. I did not die beside my lord in Alli's pit of snakes. But I can make amends. Fight me, warrior. Send me to meet him in Odin's hall.
I must wait for the ideal time to fight such a warrior of your class, Drenger. Have patience.
I will wait.
Cave. If I go any further, I should be ready to engage in combat to the death.
Aid me. Be my eyes.
Tovi, trading a needle for an arrow, I see.
Eivor, can you teach me the art of archery?
I'll be happy to. See how I'm standing? Plant your feet in the ground, no wider than your shoulders. Breathe in as you draw the arrow back. Look at the point you want to hit. And now imagine the arrow passing straight through it and far beyond. Breathe out, then release.
Thank you, Eivor. Now, I have something for you.
See? All in the eye.
Thank you, Eivor. As a gift, I could design a new tattoo for you. Something to decorate your scar.
A kind offer. But I want this scar visible.
Oh, I did not mean to offend. In any case, I do have a tattoo for you.
Can I interest you in a game of Orlok?
I do miss the rattling of luck bones.
Orlok, a game of skill, or luck. How about a game?
Let's begin.
Straight and to the point. May the best hand win.
Thank you.
Thank you. This will do.
Luck is with you this time.
Tough luck. Try again.
That is enough Orlok for now. They must be finished now.
The king has called for his best mead, so the talks are concluded. It should be safe to enter.
I'm ready to face the thunder. I'll speak with the king now.
Excellent, King Styrbjorn. I will take this proposal to my nephew. I believe he will see the wisdom in it.
Good. It is all I can hope for. May the... May the winds favor your voyage, Guthormr.
Eivor, come forward and explain in plain words why you have willfully disobeyed my commands. Do you mock me?
I do not mock you, King. I mean to embolden you against your enemies and your own poor judgment.
You know nothing of my judgment. You know nothing of my plans and strategies.
Sigurd would agree with me.
My son might agree with you, but he would obey me. He knows his place.
Not as well as he knows his father.
Imagine you are harassed by an enemy with warriors that vastly outnumber your own. What profit does open war bring? Would it not be better to work quietly through diplomacy, gaining alliances? Waiting until the day our numbers outweigh our enemies, and our victory is guaranteed.
Do we have any allies to speak of, or is that your excuse to do nothing?
Your confidence blinds you to so much in plain sight, Eivor. Day and night I toil to forge ties with clans to the north. Very soon you will see the fruits of my efforts. Only then will you understand.
Is that all?
I'm at a loss with you, Eivor. When I took you in as my own, never did I imagine such disrespect from the child of Varin. Your father was a fine man. Just and loyal to me, he died bravely so that we might live.
He died a coward, Lord. A fate I will not mirror.
Why do you carry such a useless burden? Let it go! Think only of the days to come, of your future, and the victories at hand.
My honor has been stained. Until it's wiped clean, I want nothing else.
I refuse to pick at that wound again. But if there is something that can chase these shadows from your thoughts...
Sigurd has come! Down at the docks, his ship is here!
Hey, careful with that one! Eivor!
Sigurd!
Ah, look at you, blood-soaked drinker! What, have you been worrying without me?
Ah, and you, soul-cured Vikinger. I smell the stink of a dozen kingdoms in your beard.
It's just the start. Randvi, my dear wife. Your husband returns. Bringing gifts and riches to share.
And new friends, I see.
Yes. Basim and Hytham. We met in Miklagard, and they showed me her buried secrets.
We are grateful to Sigurd for his invitation, and eager to pay tribute to your king.
My brother is always very careful with the company he keeps, if you're standing safely beside him. He must like you.
Ah, Eivor. Save the introductions until our bellies are full. I will see my father. Tell him of my time away.
This morning we traded with a ship passing south. They told us Eivor the Wolf-Kissed was captured by Kjotve's men.
They must have cut the tale short. I killed my captors and recovered my crew. For that your father scolded me. You know where I stand, brother. Nothing short of war will dislodge Kjotve from our lands. But he disagrees.
I know. Father thinks too much and acts too little. Today that changes. I promise you. By the winter's end, the name Kjotve the Cruel will be a curse on the lips of a drunken fool.
My son! Welcome home!
Father...
T
Tonight we feast and celebrate your return, Sigurd. The tables are laid with barley and lamb, bread and mead.
And no more, I beg you. I want nothing you would not serve a thrall. Let me be the one to honor you. I bring gifts and tales from faraway lands. After 2 winters away, I am full up with both.
Very well, very well. Come inside.
And when we are fat and satisfied, Father, we will talk of Kjotve and his clan, and how we may end their terror, once and for all. He has dogged us too long, shamed us for too many seasons. I know this. Eivor knows this. It ends now.
Yes, of course, when the time is right.
Through Rustland we barreled down the Volga River, raiding as we went, shadowy tribes hurling spears at our ship. At Miklagard, we saw men bedecked in riches as vibrant as the Bifröst itself. And these we took for our troubles, of course. We sailed to Rome, then Africa, past oceans of sand, warriors of all colors, and beauty the eyes must weep to behold. And now I have returned, with riches and glory to share with my family, my friends, my eyes forged Drengir. So take what you desire from my horn. For this is only a taste of things to come. Tomorrow, the Raven Clan starts anew.
Skål, Sigurd.
Skål! And you, Eivor, come. I have something special for you.
Randvi.
Eivor, have you paid a visit to Valka?
I did.
And?
It is not something I can speak on, or wish to.
I understand.
Your bed will be warm tonight with your husband returned. That must be a good feeling.
It is a different feeling. Warmer, but with less space to stretch my arms and legs.
Are you not happy to see your husband return?
Of course. But it has been so long he seems a stranger to me. 3 winters we are married, and he has been away for 2.
Can you not rekindle the flame that once burned hot?
When he crawls into bed to warm me, as you say, it will be with farts and honeyed breath.
Ah, we should all be so lucky. Sigurd has raised the reputation of this clan to new heights, Lord. We could not have asked for a more joyous return.
Oh, but we could have. Had Sigurd spent his last 2 winters here, in Fornburg, defending our lands, we might have been rid of Kjotve by now.
You always said we needed more warriors to fight Kjotve. And for warriors, we need wealth, which Sigurd has brought us.
The wealth he brings will not buy us an army. It only buys us time before our end.
You talk like a man with 1 foot in Helheim. Have you no plan of your own to rid this land of our enemy? Will it fall to Sigurd and me?
I do, but it will fall to you and Sigurd to accept it. And I must have your word that you will.
If you so order it, my king, it will be done. You have my axe until the end.
We shall see.
Hytham, is it?
Yes, and you are Eivor.
I am. I hope this ruckus does not overwhelm you. We tend to drink and talk at equal speed.
Not at all. The wood smoke from your fire pit does sting the eyes, but the warmth is welcome.
Of course. It must be rather warm where you live.
Where I live changes from week to week. But always, I am with my mentor, Basim.
Your mentor? For what cause?
A noble one. A cause as true as the world is old. But let us leave it at that for now.
I understand. But if you hope to stay tight-lipped for the rest of the night, keep clear of Tekla's meat.
Ah, thank you for the warning. It will not be a problem.
You're Basim.
You have a good memory.
And you have no mead. Can I fix that?
Sigurd spoke often of you on our journey. Called you his right arm. A celebrated warrior. I am honored to meet you.
Likewise, Basim. And how did you come to meet my brother?
He set down in Constantinople some months ago to rest and resupply, he told me. But I knew otherwise. Men with eyes that gleam like his are always up to something more. I think he wished to raid the Hagia Sophia.
That sounds right.
I will not bore you with the details of her meeting. But I liked your brother from the first. I saw something in him that captivated me. As if a forgotten memory of an old friendship had suddenly resurfaced.
He has that effect on people. Enjoy your evening, Basim.
I thought long and hard on a gift worthy of him.
You have snared my curiosity, brother. What is it?
Not yet. Drinks first. To my first night in Thornburg in over two winters. It must end with me soaked and wall-eyed, shouting at the shadows of trolls.
And you want me to sail with you on these honey waves?
Yes. You are stuck with me, Dringur. Now drink. Ah, oh, you would put Thor to shame.
Forgive me. On your first day back, I should have let you win.
Gods, you should have let me start.
It is good to have you back, Sigurd.
Yes. I've missed this terribly. When I first met Basim, I regaled him with tales of our homeland. And it was then I felt a heart longing to return at once. Come. This brings us to your gift. These excellent men were my shepherds through much of their homeland, the Abbasid Caliphate. They are a clan, not joined by blood, but by a common idea. A brotherhood of shadows executing their own form of justice. In my time with them, they shared many of their most hidden secrets, for which I am grateful. And now, I gift one of these secrets to you. Weapon for the finest warrior I know.
Beautiful craftsmanship. What kind of smith makes a weapon like this?
It is less a weapon than a tool. One we have used for centuries to fight injustice and evil.
Mentor, I must protest. This is deeply unorthodox. Our wrist blade is a sacred tool.
Do not make a fetish out of cold metal, Haifa. What matters is the mind of the one who wields it. Please, try it on. The blade should ride on the underside of your arm to conceal it from your target.
I have no wish to hide this, and I would rather not make the same mistake you two have. I like it.
This is no mistake. This is a voluntary sacrifice to prove our devotion to...
A good start, Eivor. But you must learn how to use it effectively.
Outside. This is not something for all eyes.
Lead on. This clan of yours, it has a name.
Indeed. But among the tenets of our creed is a vow to never reveal too much to outsiders. In time, you may learn more. But not here, where the walls and trees may have ears.
I look forward to it.
Here, let me lead you through our most basic techniques. Wielded with skill and care, our blade delivers a singular killing blow. As you near your target, find your window to strike. Timing is essential.
Excellent.
I have not seen a blade so sharp.
Some targets are trickier than others. Keep that in mind before you strike.
A decent attempt.
Take that one down from the ledge. Exactly, just like that.
How about a challenge? Leap down upon that target from above.
A perfect strike. Use your surroundings when possible. Strike from that haystack, for instance. That's it.
Mentor, does Eivor intend to join us?
Not that I am aware.
Then why offer her the blade? Surely we have more.
Hush. You wield the blade well. Let us leave Eivor to enjoy her gift in peace. Come.
Eivor, let us walk to the docks and take in the night air. What do you make of my new friends?
They seem generous and menacing in equal measure.
I know what you mean. And they have learning, too. They wield numbers and writing as if it were magic. Basim has shown me so much about the world, all of which I will share with you when the time is right. Oh, I miss the smell of this land.
Have you returned for good? Or do you mean to join this Shadow Brotherhood?
Leave all that aside, Eivor. Tonight we are family again. The here and now is what matters. Our kinship. Our clan. Our glory.
I missed you, brother. Your clear head and your courage. We have not had enough of both in recent months.
You flatter me, Wolfkist. Keep it up.
From here to Valhalla, I will always be at your side, Sigurd. Always.
This fjord has grown too small to contain me, or I too large. There is so much more beyond these stony fangs that rise around us. England, Ireland, Francia, all greener pastures, ripe for the plucking. Tomorrow, we make new war on Gjotve. And reclaim the lands he took from us. And from there, we build a kingdom for us.
I'm with you. Only say the word.
Good. Get some rest, and return here at first light.
The Nornir have spoken. You will betray Sigurd.
No, this is wrong. That cannot be right. Odin fought against his fate. It can be done.
You will betray Sigurd.
Shit. Kjotve's warriors.
One would not have come alone. I should find the others. Go, Sunin.
that feeling, just the three of us. We should return to Northfall with our report, while we can.
We can bring Jut the news of the long... Or we can wake him with Sigurd Styrbjörnsson's head. Which is better?
All right. When Jut returns, we weigh our next move. But I am not one for sticking around, hear me?
Quit bawling, you babe. They may be drunk, but they're not dead.
Know about this.
With each day we wait, Kjotve grows stronger.
We do not have the men to storm Kjotve's fortress. The losses would ruin us.
The losses have ruined us, father. Until we cut off this serpent's head, it will poison us day by day, drop by drop.
The poison has already polluted our waters.
Gods, Eivor, what happened?
Spies in our camp. Three men sent by Kjotve to kill us as we slept. I returned the favor.
There, you see? This is what waiting brings. We must answer this insult.
They came from Notfall, that wailing village under Kjotve's control.
We hid him there. Burn it down before Kjotve learns his spies are dead.
He may have sent more. I can search the village while you round up the crew.
No need. I will send Hytham to search the area. You can rely on him while we are away.
We? Do you mean to join us?
I have not been bred for Valhalla like you, but this will be far from my first battle.
I do not like this, but I will not stop you. Do not lead my son into the same storm that follows you.
To the waves. Let the sail out!
Warriors! Grengi! When I was away, far from these frozen shores, wondering if I should ever see home again, I grew afraid. Afraid I would not return in time to see Kurtwe's end. Afraid I would not see him bleed out like a stuck pig in a drift of snow. But here I am, home in time to join those I have missed, those I love, in this glorious fight. Today we seize Nokfall from Kurtwe. Tonight his heart will pulse with worry. Tomorrow it will burst from fear. He will beseech the gods for aid, for they will be deaf to his cries. And soon, the Raven Clan will feast on his death! You know these isles best, Wolfkist. Lead us to victory.
I will show the way, but you must lead us there.
Oh, Eivor. I missed having you at my side. How I wished I could have taken you along on my travels.
Styrbjörn did not trust fate with both our lives.
We have no reason to fear. Together, we are unstoppable.
Thank you. Watch your backs!
Coming!
different clan. You reap a bloody harvest. Who are you, Gester? Name yourself.
I know his face. He met with your father not long ago.
I did, indeed. I am Guthorm, uncle to King Harald of the North. I speak for my nephew when there is need. This is not King Harald's land. Why does he send warriors so far south? You may ask him yourself, my lord.
Thank you, uncle. And you are Sigurd of the Raven Clan, is that right? Son of the wise King Styrbjörn.
I am. And you are standing on his land, King Harald. Land we have reclaimed with blood and steel.
That I see, and I honor it, for I have not come to war against you, but for you, at the request of your father.
The canny wolf. Was this the plan he spoke of?
I offer my support. With my warriors, your Raven Clan can take Kjotve's fortress and settle this rivalry for good.
This is good news, Eivor. The Wandering King will tip our fortunes.
Any man who wishes to see the end of Kjotve is a friend of mine. We thank you, King Harald.
Your trust in me will be repaid.
This blood feud runs deep, King Harald. We welcome your help, but I must lead the charge.
I see. Is this a question of honor?
It is. Many winters ago, Kjotve broke an oath to our fathers. He betrayed a friendly peace and slaughtered many.
I understand. Sigurd Jarl will lead the assault against Kjotve and his clan. Give him full command of my ships and my warriors. When your victory is in hand, Sigurd, find me at Alrekstadir, and we will celebrate together.
Our men will gather at Florli, near the mouth of the fjord northeast of here. Will you join us? Hold a moment. You captain our longship, Eivor. Meet us there, and we will claim Kjotve's head for the gods.
Brother, I have waited too many years for this day. When Kjotve stands before us, give me the final blow.
You will have it, Eivor. You deserve it.
Eivor! Give us a hand! Harald is generous with his troops. More than I would be.
I cannot fathom his game. He's either a young fool, or deceptively wise.
Whatever his reason, I have a good feeling this war is near its end.
Eivor, you missed the opening act. Kjotve's forward camp melted like a spring thaw at our approach.
Is it from here we launch our attack?
We do indeed, and
we are ready to fight. King Harald's forces are well in place. Only give the word.
I will, but before we strike, I have a request.
Name it.
The neighbor may give challenge to Kjotve at the gate of his fortress. A battle to the death in single combat.
Is this what you want?
Kjotve robbed my father of all honor and dignity. I will win it back.
When honor is at stake, let none interfere. And if Kjotve should die before the battle begins, all the better for our chances.
Today, my blade must do the work of Skull's sharp scissors, and cut short the cord of Kjotve's fate.
Well said, my sharp-tongued warrior scald. May we all live to hear that saga sung.
Eivor, a word!
Basim, Hytham. This feud is not yours, yet you fight it all the same. I find that strange.
You find it strange because you are wrong. Our clan, the Hidden Ones, have been fighting with Kjotve's order for centuries.
You came from Miklagard to kill Kjotve yourself.
We did. Or rather, we came so that Hytham could kill him. My apprentice has been studying this target for many months.
Is Kjotve's reputation so great outside Norway?
Not his reputation alone, but the order to which he belongs. Something of a rival clan to our own.
Hytham, I mean no disrespect to you or the Hidden Ones, but Kjotve is mine. My family's honor is at stake.
I understand. All that matters is that Kjotve dies this day.
On that, we are agreed.
Sigurd Horsson! Slink around my walls like a thief in the night. Face me here now.
The fight is mine, Kjotve. Sigurd is only here to watch me feed your innards to my raven.
Look at this! Once again, Eivor Wolfkist appears to take a swipe at me.
This is my father's shame. Today I take back the honor he lost.
I call a Holmgang! Here! Against the Oathbreaker!
I will make you beg as your father begged, Wolfkiss. Squeal as your mother squealed.
Life, I will take yours.
You are weak, like your father was weak. Pray for death. Worm. You dance better than you fight.
Your day to die.
Why do you refuse to die?
We are not alone, Kjotve. The old father watches. My
My blade will drink your blood.
Your flesh will feed my wolves. Shameful trick, Wolfkist. You are your father's child.
Ravenclan! Your lives are forfeit! Come forward if you must! Into the crucible of your doom!
Your father is dead, Gorm! His debt's repaid!
Open the gates and you will be spared!
Wallow in shit, wolf kissed. Archers, take aim!
Ravens, show no mercy!
Archers, fire!
Watch my back. Gold Grunt!
pursuit of vengeance has made you predictable.
You are a shadow of your father, Gorm. Weak and witless.
And you will leave this place as ashes on the wind.
Gorm flees. His father dies twice today.
The breath of battle rises from my brow. The skulls will sing of this night.
We have won the day, but Gorm escaped and fled north to King Harald's domain.
Let that bruised piglet run where he may. His father is dead. His clan is no more. We are the masters of Ruyavilke.
The toothless cub may grow to be a dangerous wolf.
Eivor, stop. And listen. You have reclaimed your honor. Enjoy the night's victory. Tomorrow, we will celebrate.
You're right, brother. You are always right.
Guthormr, relay news of our victory to your nephew, the king.
I have done so already, Sigurd. You'll be more than pleased. I will ensure you pride of place at his Althing at Alrekstadir.
Tell him we will come, battle flushed and singing songs of glory.
Keep company with kings, and you will soon have a crown of your own.
If the fates have spun it so, linger here and loot what you can. I will bring news of our victory to father before he leaves for Harald's Althing.
I know, Sunna. Another time.